If you create org charts, you should watch this video. This is the second part of the series. The first part, we saw how to create org charts using PowerPoint. In this part, we are going to see how to create them using Excel and Visio together. In Excel, in order to use Visio, we have to install this add-in called Visio Data Visualizer. If you don't see it in the Insert menu, go to Get Add-ins, My Add-ins, and here search for it. And you will find Microsoft Visio Data Visualizer. Just add it and then you will have this button. Now, when you click on this button, it initializes itself and gives you these three categories of visualizations or charts. Two are flow charts and one is org chart. In this video, we are only going to focus on the org chart. There are five types on the face of it. Basically, they are different in terms of layout. The way data is used is exactly the same across all of them. So let's go to quick start. The moment you click on create, it will add some data automatically and try to generate an org chart based on that. This data, there are three rows, so there are three people. Now each row has five columns. The first column is ID. Name is the name of the person, of course. Title is the title. The fourth column is very important. This is the one which decides the hierarchy. So what is it saying? This person whose ID is ID 2, ID 1 is the boss. The ID 3 person also reports to ID 1. And the top boss, ID 1, manager ID is empty. So this is shown on the top. The last column, executive manager, manager, is not being visually shown here in terms of text, but the formatting is different. So we have director shown as blue and manager shown as green. Seven types available here. And depending on which type you choose, you get a different kind of color coding. Now let's come back and understand what else can we do here. First thing is you can put your employee IDs directly here. Now remember, if you are putting someone's name here as manager ID, that person should exist here. Now if I try to put some ID which is not there in the first column, it will give you a warning. Now let's look at another example. I have kept IDs 1 to 8 and then I have put various names. Department 1 has a boss, Department 2 has a boss, and each one of them have three people reporting to them. To understand how this works, I have currently kept all manager IDs empty. These are executives and the others are managers. So now the chart shows everyone being at the same level because manager IDs are empty. In order to make these three people report to the Department 1 boss, I have to put the ID of the Department 1 boss, which is ID 1. And here, Department 2 boss ID is ID 5. So now when I refresh it, it will show departmental heads not having any bosses and their subordinates being shown correctly. There is a limit, of course. There are maximum 100 people or rows supported in this. If you want data from Excel and more than 100 rows and complex, then you have to buy Visio actual product. Now the question is, having done all this, obviously you want to use this diagram elsewhere. And the sad part is there is no copy button. Point is, if it is a small diagram, you can just resize it and take a screenshot. But that may not always be. In that case, what do you do? Click on this three dots and say open in web. Now open this file. It does not require any installation. It will open on browser itself. Solution is go to these three dots and then say download as image. And once it is an image, then of course you can insert it anywhere. So that's how you use Excel along with Visio to create org charts. Have a look at the first part with PowerPoint and the third part with Visio itself. So that's it for now. Thank you.